Hi friends, today we are going to see a new topic which is in the which is as a part of a digital signal processing, and we are going to derive or devise a mechanism or a new device which is used in digital telephony. So the topic for today in the application of digital telephony is DTMF using Goertzel's algorithm. So I'll be using DTMF, or we will be using Goertzel's algorithm to detect DTMF signals in digital telephony. So let us first understand what you mean by DTMF. So DTMF stands for dual tone multiple frequencies. Okay, so DTMF stands for, D stands for dual, T stands for tone, M stands for multiple, and F stands for frequency. So dual tone multiple frequency mechanism we will be using, and why we will use that also we will see very shortly. But we'll be using Goertzel's algorithm to detect this multi-tone or dual tone multiple frequencies. Okay, now in digital telephone or in any telephone, probably you have a dialing or you have a dialer. Okay, now in the previous era or during the very early stages of the technology of telephone, we know that there was a mechanical dial which, when we have to put our finger into a number and then rotate it, the number of rotation that goes, the numbers are detected accordingly. So that was a completely mechanical process. Now using the electronics switching mechanism, we have developed a electronically switching mechanism or electronic switches. So how does this electronic switches understand when we press a switch it is number one, or when we press a switch it is number two? For example, when I dial 022, okay, how does electronically we should understand that I have pressed 022? So this dual tone multiple frequency is being used in the dialer mechanism to understand how to analyze the numerical values. Sometimes we also gave a liberty that, okay, you use numerical values also, but you use some special keys also. For example, we use some special key called star, or we use hash, isn't it? So this type of special keys are also there on our keypad. So how does the keypad or how does the telephone understand that which button has been pressed or which number has been pressed on the keypad? So we have developed a mechanism or an intelligent system which we called as dual tone multiple frequency, in which we have this arrangement. Now you can see there are some vertical green lines and horizontal red lines, and next to each line I have written a frequency. So what we did is, based on the numbers that we are going to put, or based on the numbers that were being put on the telephone, normally was 0 to 9 and these two special keys. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so 12 total combination of 12 total keys were there with me, and we have decided that we will set up different frequency for particular key. For example, if I press number 1, one frequency will be generated. If I press number 2, another frequency will be generated. But what we have used in the normal keypad is, instead of generating one frequency, we develop a column, a matrix of frequency, in which there are some columns and there are some rows. For the rows, we have low frequencies. For the columns, we have high frequency. So whenever a key is being pressed, that time we will get a low frequency generated along with a high frequency generated. So if suppose I pressed 022 number, so I press 022, okay, associated with 0. Now with respect to 0, associated with 0, the frequency that will be getting generated in the row, that is a low frequency row, is 941 hertz. whereas the column frequency is 1336 Hz. So whenever I press a number, okay, two tone frequency or two tones are generated, or multiple frequencies are generated. One frequency will be higher and one frequency will be lower. So when I press 0, for example, we will press 0. When I press 0, that time I am going to get frequencies as 941 Hz and 1336 Hz. When I press 2, that time, which two frequencies? 697 Hz, and okay, the column over here is again 1336 Hz. Okay, and again when I press 2, it is again 697 Hz and 1336 Hz. So in a given interval, when you press, okay, for a given span of time, a continuous tone is generated for a given period of time, and that continuous tone have two frequencies. One is a lower frequency and one is a higher frequency. At the detector, my job is to pull out this lower frequency component and higher frequency component correctly so that I can understand that what number was dialed. So because we are using two frequencies, it is called as dual tone, because tone is associated, because these are two sine waves. Okay, so that's why we are saying it as dual tone, multiple frequency. So this is the meaning of DTMF. Now let us understand how Goertzel's algorithm help us in understanding this frequencies. So what we basically do is, in this algorithm, what I'm going to do is, we are getting a linear PCM input. Basically, the voice signals are pulse code modulated when they are transmitted over the line. We speak analogly, or we speak analog signal. That speech signals are in the range of 0 to roughly around 4 kilohertz, but actual number is 3.4 kilohertz. But we are taking up to 4 kilohertz, and then we are sampling it at a rate of 8 kilohertz, that is to satisfy the Nyquist criteria. Once we sample it at 8 kilohertz, then we send it to a coder, and then coder will assign 8 bits per sample. Okay, so the approximate rate comes to be 64 kbps for one voice channel. Okay, so what happens is, whenever I press a tone, okay, with these two frequencies, what is going to happen? The highest frequency will be considered, and then it will be getting into, and then we are going to sample it by the highest frequency, isn't it? We cannot sample it by 8 kilohertz. Okay, so what is happening is, now I'm getting number tones and we are getting